Joyfully singing songs, if today you hear his voice, harden not your heart. If today you hear his voice. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, on behalf of Sophia and Francis, I welcome you here to St. Marguerite de Ville Parish. On this beautiful day, as Sophia and Francis prepare to exchange their vows of love for one another, we are reminded by the Bible that the sacrament of marriage is a sacred sacrament. It represents the love that God has for his people. And so, as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our need for God's mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who since the beginning of the world have blessed the increase of offspring, show favor to our supplications and pour forth the help of your blessing on Sophia and Francis, so that in the union of marriage they may be bound together in mutual affection, in likeness of mind, and in shared holiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Then the Lord God said, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper as his partner." So out of the ground the Lord God formed every animal of the field and every bird of the air, and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all cattle, and to the birds of the air, and to every animal of the field. But for the man, there was not found a helper as his partner. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. Then he took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called a woman, for out of man this one was taken. Therefore, a man leaves his father and his mother and clings to his wife, and they become one flesh." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks for God's steadfast love, God's mercy. Let all those
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Galatians. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts. Sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
John, glory to you, O Lord. On the third day, there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples had also been invited to the wedding. When the wine gave out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what concern is that to you and to me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now standing there were six stone water jars for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding about 100 liters. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water." And they filled them to the brim. He said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the chief steward." So they took it. When the steward tasted the water that had become wine and did not know where it came from, he called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves the good wine first and then the inferior wine after the guests have become drunk, but you have kept the good wine until now." Jesus did this, the first of his signs in Cana of Galilee, and revealed his glory, and his disciples believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Sophia and Francis, as you are surrounded by your family and friends on this beautiful day and are preparing to make your vows of love to one another, I'm sure that there are many feelings and emotions going through your minds and hearts, but because this is a sacred celebration, I ask you to put your worries aside, let your minds be at ease, and let us for a few moments reflect on the Word of God that we have listened to, because the Word of God is to help you
in your life, but especially now that you are entering into the sacrament of marriage. So, as we heard in today's first reading from the book of Genesis, after Almighty God created the whole universe, he created human beings in his own likeness. And after he created the first man, he brought to him all sorts of creatures, hoping that he would be happy. But none of those creatures were to satisfy the longing of the man for happiness. And so that is when God created the first woman. And Adam exclaims, "This at last is bone from my bone and flesh from my flesh." And so Adam shows that he is truly happy because he has found someone who is his equal, someone who he can share his life with, someone who can truly make him happy. And so that is what marriage is all about. It is about a man and a woman finding each other and living according to God's plan so that they can be truly happy and support each other and love each other and be there for each other in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, until death. And then the gospel that I just read to you from St. John tells us of the first miracle that our Lord performed. And the fact that Jesus performs his first miracle at a wedding banquet tells us how he holds marriage to be such an important sacrament. And as we probably already know about this miracle, Jesus and his mother and his disciples were invited to this wedding banquet. And everyone's enjoying themselves, and someone starts whispering that the wine for the reception has run out. Now imagine how embarrassing it would have been for the newly married couple to find out that their guests aren't able to enjoy each other and the company that they have that evening. And so someone comes to Mary, the mother of Jesus, and says, "Could you do something?" And Mary, because she has a mother's heart, feels sorry for the couple and goes to Jesus and says, "They've run out of wine." And at first Jesus says, "It's none of my business." But Mary prevails. And Jesus, the obedient son, says to them, "Fill these jars with water." And there were 6 stone water jars that could hold 100 liters of water, which we are told were meant for the purification rites of the Jews. And when they drew the water out, it had changed into wine, and the celebration could go on, and the bride and groom were spared any embarrassment. So what does that say to you, Sophia and Francis, as you enter into this sacred bond of marriage? It simply means that, first and foremost, because you were raised Catholic by your parents, you know the importance of Jesus in your life. He is the Lord who, out of love for us, went to the cross in order to save us from our sins and bring us to the kingdom of heaven. So by being married here in the church today, what you have said to Jesus is, "You are important in my life, and I invite you not into my life, but also into my marriage." And what the Lord says, "Thank you for your invitation, and just as I performed my first miracle and changed the water into wine at the wedding feast of Cana in Galilee, I will be there for you in your marriage, as long as you continue to trust in me, as long as you continue to invite me by practicing your faith in me, by keeping my commandments, by participating in the Sunday Eucharist, by praying together, by raising the children, that I will bless you in the Catholic faith so that you are able to be faithful to me and I will be faithful to you." So that is really the message for you, Sophia and Francis, as you enter into the sacred bond, that by being married here in the church today, you have invited the Lord into your life, and he assures you that he will bless you
beyond your imaginations. Remember, one last thing before we continue is that sometimes people think that a marriage is between husband and wife alone. But as Christians, we believe that by inviting the Lord into our marriage, there are three people: husband, wife, and the Lord Jesus Christ. And so if you remember that, then in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, the Lord will be there for you to strengthen you and to sustain your marriage so that it may last forever. I now invite everyone to please stand for the vows. My dear friends, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and this community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Sophia and Francis, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely, and wholeheartedly? Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church? Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and His church. I, Francis, take you, Sophia, to be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life. I, Sophia, take you, Francis, to be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life. May the Lord, in His kindness, strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment His blessing within you. What God joins together, let no one put asunder. May the Lord bless these rings, which you will give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity. Sophia, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Francis, receive this ring
as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Sophia and Francis, you have exchanged your sacred vows and your rings. I now invite you to seal your covenant with a kiss.
The person who will be reading the prayers of the faithful to please come forward. Dear brothers and sisters, as we call to mind the special gift of grace and charity by which God has been pleased to crown and consecrate the love of Sophia and Francis, let us commend them to the Lord. Our response to each of these petitions will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the newly married couple, that every day of their lives, Sophia and Francis may renew their desire to grow in love for each other and the gift they make today of their very selves. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all married people, for all married couples present here, that they may renew their commitment to love and to share with the world the mystery of God's friendship, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, for God's holy people, that through this celebration we all may grow in our desire to serve and love the world, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, for the world that in its hunger for love it may turn to Christ and acknowledge Him as Lord. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of Sophia and Francis who have died and for those who feel their absence most keenly at this time of joy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Graciously pour out upon this husband and wife, O Lord, the spirit of your love, to make them one heart and one soul, so that nothing whatsoever may divide those you have joined, and no harm come to those you have filled with your blessing. Through Christ our Lord, amen. I now invite the mother of Sophia and the mother of Francis to please come forward for the lighting of the unity candle. Sophia and Francis will now take the candles that were lit by their mothers, representing the lives that they received from their mothers, and now unite them in the central candle, which represents that they are no longer two, but one in the sacrament of matrimony. Thank you. I now invite the cord sponsors to place the cord on our newly married couple. At this time, as I prepare the altar for the Holy Eucharist, I invite everyone to be seated, and the cord and the veil will then be removed.
If there never was a speaker, then there never be a song. If there never
acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all of his holy church.
Please stand. Receive in your kindness, O Lord, the offerings we bring in gladness before you, and in your fatherly love, watch over those you have joined in a sacramental covenant. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in him you have made a new covenant with your people, so that as you have redeemed man and woman by the mystery of Christ's death and resurrection, so in Christ you might make them partakers of divine nature and joint heirs with him of heavenly glory. In the union of husband and wife, you give a sign of Christ's loving gift of grace, so that the sacrament we celebrate might draw us back more deeply into the wonderful design of your love. And so with all the angels and all the saints, we praise you, and without end, we acclaim. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Lord, renew your church by the light of the gospel. Strengthen the bond of unity between the faithful and the pastors of your people, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all your people. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Sisters, in the sacrament of baptism, God made us his sons and daughters, and so we have the courage to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. At this time, I invite our newly married couple to please kneel for the nuptial blessing. Heavenly Father, maker of the whole world, who created man and woman in your own image and willed that their union be crowned with your blessing, we humbly beseech you for these, your servants, who are joined today in the sacrament of matrimony. May your abundant blessing, Lord, come down upon this bride, Sophia, and upon Francis, her companion for life, and may the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out together the gift of matrimony, they may adorn their family with children and enrich the church. In happiness, may they praise you, O Lord. In sorrow, may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil and know that you are near to comfort them in their need. Let them pray to you in the Holy Assembly and bear witness to you in the world. And after a happy old age, together with the circle of friends that surrounds them, may they come to the kingdom of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please stand. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please be seated. Just one announcement, a reminder about Holy Communion. Just as our Lord Jesus Christ changed the water into wine at the wedding feast of Cana, as Catholics we believe that during the celebration of Holy Mass, God transforms the bread and wine into the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, and calls his faithful sons and daughters to be nourished as we journey towards our heavenly inheritance. Those Catholics who are able to receive the Lord Jesus Christ in a worthy manner are welcome at this time to come forward to receive Holy Communion. All others may remain seated, or if you prefer a blessing, please indicate that by crossing your arms over your chest. Let us pray. Please stand. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the power of the sacrament we have received may find growth in these, your servants, and that the effects of the sacrifice we have offered may be felt by us all. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. For this final solemn blessing, there are three parts. After each part, I will pause, and I invite you to respond, Amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May the Lord Jesus, who graced the marriage at Cana by his presence, bless you and your loved ones. Amen. May he, who loved the church to the end, unceasingly pour his love into your hearts. Amen. May the Lord grant that bearing witness to faith in his resurrection, you may await with joy the blessed hope to come. Amen. And may Almighty God bless all of you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I now invite everyone to please be seated for the signing of the marriage papers.
This moment, life has begun.
From this moment, you are the one. Right beside you is where I belong. From this moment on, from this moment, I have been blessed. I live only for your happiness and for your love. I give my last breath from this moment on. I give my hand to you with all my heart. Can't wait to live my life with you. Can't wait to start.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce to you, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Juaneza.